Dear students, today we'll try to know about the news number. It is called a complex number. First of all, complex numbers. A complex number is a number of the form. It is a plus ib, where here A is called real part and B is called imaginary part of complex number. And the value of I is called root of minus 1. Complex number generally we are going to denote by an alphabet Z. Therefore we can write Z is equal to A plus IB. I'll give an example to note that here. Example, 2 plus 3i is a complex number, where 2 is real part and 3 is imaginary part. Similarly, root 3 plus 2i, here root 3 is real part and 2 is imaginary part. Note that 0 is also a complex number. Though we are observing that here it is a complex number, it must contain two parts. Here you will find only one part, one 0 here. We can, even though it contains 0, we can represent it as in the complex form. 0 is equal to 0 plus I into 0. Then here real part is also 0 and imaginary part is also equal to 0. Similarly, 1 is a real number as well as it is a complex number. We can write 1 as 1 plus I into 0. Here real part is 1 and imaginary part is 0. Similarly, we can generalize this. Every real number is a complex number, but a complex number is not a real number. Note that 3i is a complex number here, but it is not a real number. Here real part is 0 and imaginary part is 3. So this is an example to a complex number. Now we will continue that. Here it is. Set, as every number has a notation, has a set, we will express in terms of a set. In the same manner, set of complex number we are going to represent in the form C, that A plus IB, where A comma B belongs to set of real numbers and the value of I is equal to root minus 1. This notation I, first time it has given by Euler, and I is imaginary. We will observe that if any higher power of I, we can simplify this in this manner. Now we define here I square is equal to minus 1. Therefore, any higher power of I, we can represent in the form I cube. For example, I cube, we can write it as I square into I. I square is equal to minus 1 into I, it is equal to minus I. Therefore, I cube is equal to how much? Minus I. Similarly, I to the power 4 is equal to, we can write it as I square whole square, and it is equal to minus 1 square, it is equal to 1. Similarly, if I will take one more, suppose if it is I to the power 10, then this is equal to I square to the power 5, it is equal to minus 1 to the power 5, you know that it is equal to minus 1. Still higher power if I will take here, I to the power 250 I have taken here, then you are observing that, taking I square as standard, we can write it as I square to the power 125 power. Therefore, this is equal to minus 1, 125, and you know that this is what, therefore it is equal to minus 1, etc. In this manner, any higher power of I, we can simplify. Yes, after knowing this, we will try to know about how to add to complex number, subtract to complex number, multiply and division of two complex numbers. Before that, we will call it as algebra of complex number. Algebra of complex numbers. Complex numbers. Yes. Before going to that, we'll try to know about equality of complex numbers. Equality of complex numbers. Equality of complex numbers. Yes. When two complex numbers are said to be equal. Suppose if I take say z1 is equal to a1 plus ib1 and z2 is equal to another complex number a2 plus ib2. So always you have to note that a1, a2, comma b1, b2, they are all real numbers, belongs to real numbers here. Now when z1 equal to z2, that is only when, that means here z1 is a1 plus ib1 and z2 is a2 plus ib2. So as usual, you know that when we can put equality between them, only when real part is equal to real part is equal to real part, and imaginary part is equal to imaginary part is equal to imaginary part. That means here a1 is equal to a2 and b1 is equal to b2. So therefore, the two equality of complex numbers we can define only when real part of one complex number is equal to real part of another complex number. Similarly, imaginary part of one complex number is equal to imaginary part of another complex number. Say for example, if I take here this z1 is equal to say a plus ib and z2 is equal to 3 plus 4i. I will put the condition here, z1 is equal to, if z1 is equal to z2, then find a and b. As a small example, if you consider that finding out the unknown a and b here. Now they are given that here it is z1 equal to z2. So therefore, z1 is equal to a plus ib and z2 is equal to 3 plus 4i. They are given it is equal to equal. So I am using equality of complex number to find a and b. So by the definition of equality, you will observe that when they are going to be equal, as I have told here, a is equal to 3 and b is equal to 4. Therefore, here you have found out the unknown a and b here. Similarly, now we try to define addition of complex number. Addition, yes. As addition as well as subtraction of complex number. As you have studied, addition and subtraction are the set of integers, real numbers, etc. in the elementary class. Now in the same manner, consider z1 is equal to a1 plus ib1 and z2 is equal to a2 plus ib2. We can define z1 plus z2 is the definition here. We can define z1 plus z2 as a1 plus ib1 plus a2 plus ib2, that is equal to, we can define the addition of complex numbers as adding real part to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. That means a1 plus a2 plus I, you can take outside, I here it is common, you can simplify that directly. and this is V1 plus V2.
Right.
Once again you will find that here it is, sum of two real numbers is again a real here. I am writing this as A3 and this is I. V1 plus V2 is again a real number here. I am writing this as V3. Therefore you will find that while adding two complex number, you will get again a complex number form. Complex number. And this belongs to the set C. Therefore, we will say that the addition of complex number is well defined. See, for example, to understand this here it is, if I take, say, Z1 is equal to 1 plus I. I'll take another here, Z2 is equal to, say, 3 plus 2I. Then, Z1 plus Z2 is equal to 1 plus I plus 3 plus 2I. That is equal to, as I have defined you, adding real part to real part, 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 plus I plus I is equal to, I plus 2I is equal to 3I. So therefore, once again, this belongs to, this is a complex number. Here you have to note that real part is 4 and imaginary part is 3, etc. Again, similarly, we are going to define difference between or subtraction of the complex number. Again, I am going to consider in the same manner that Z1 is equal to A1 plus IB1 and Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2. Then again, Z1 minus Z2 is equal to, in the same fashion as you have defined addition, the subtraction is also going to define. That is A1 plus IB1 minus A2 plus IB2. That is equal to, again in the same manner, A1 minus A2 plus I V1 minus V2, and that is equal to A3 plus IB3. This is once again a complex number, belongs to the set of complex number. Hence, subtraction of the two complex number is once again a complex number. So here I will wind up the here I will stop the session. I will continue the session in the next class. Thank you.